So today we want to look at creating a mentally balanced horse and what that means. So plenty of people do groundwork or know that it's important to do groundwork, but they don't really understand the why of each exercise and what the benefit to the horse is. So I want to demonstrate a little bit with Arlen here first up of how we can move her feet to get her focused on us and not worried about where her friends are or going back to the stable or the paddock or wherever she might be wanting to go. So to fix, you know, separation anxiety and other issues like that, we can use our groundwork exercises to develop a bit of confidence and respect in the horse so that she's paying more attention to us and less attention to everything else. So starting with sending her out on the circle, we're going to ask her to travel around on the circle in the direction that I've sent her, maintaining her pace on her own without me having to continually drive her forward. Then I'm going to ask her to disengage her hind quarter and change direction. So the purpose of this exercise is to get her focused on me, thinking about moving her feet where I'm directing them, and getting her attention on me and not on everything else that's going on around her, not worrying about where her friends are. So we're going to start off by simply sending her out, see how responsive she is to that, and if she can go out and maintain that circle on her own. If she can do that, then we can move into the change of direction and have multiple changes of direction through the disengage to have her start to focus on where I'm asking her to put her feet. So I'm going to start in front of her, I'm going to point in the direction I want her to go, and then if she doesn't go straight away, I'm going to use my tail end of my rope to drive her forward. So I want her to start there, I'm going to have a bit of slack in my rope, I'm going to point, there she starts to go. So at the moment we don't worry if she's going at a walk or a trot, as long as she goes when I ask her to go and doesn't try to stop, she's maintaining that pace on her own. So she's happy to maintain that circle so I can disengage her and ask her to go again. So put a bit of pressure towards her hind end, ask her to disengage and stop facing me again. She tries to come forward, I'm just going to correct her, ask her to stop back there. So I'm going to point out. This time getting more pressure, ask her to go up into the trot. And here she should travel around the circle without me having to constantly drive her forward. Quite happy trotting around. I'm going to ask her to disengage. I'm going to send her to the other direction. So there, she's a bit lazy, a bit more pressure, get her going forward. Starts to focus her attention on me, you should start to notice how she's bending in through her body. She should be wanting to look into the circle and have less desire to pull her head out or look to the outside of the circle. So there, she wants to play right to disengage and change. More pressure, get her going a bit more forward. Better. Still a little bit sticky in that change of direction. Starting to bend nicer.
Getting a bit of shape through every rib cage here and there. So we might let her stop there. Good. And just throw the rope over her back to make sure she's still relaxed. So we go from sensitizing to desensitizing to make sure that our horse is responsive but also relaxed. So we don't want her responsive but worried and anxious, and we don't want her really relaxed to the point where she's dull and lazy. We want to have a mentally balanced horse, so that means responsive but also relaxed. But just rub until her head lowers and she starts to show those signs of relaxation like that. Good girl. So then again, we're going to send her off. There, good. Yeah, she's starting to soften and bend a little bit. So I might direct a little bit of energy at her hind quarter. So we're sort of asking for a partial disengagement, just to get her bending a bit more now. So I'm just using my rope and my body language just to direct some energy towards that inside hind foot. So you see now she's starting to step through a bit better. Starting to bend and get a bit of nice shape out. There, where she wants to come back, drive her up again. So I'm trying to have as little pressure on the halter as possible and focus on driving that hip. There, ask her to disengage. Didn't quite go all the way. Make her follow through. And then again, desensitize to make sure she's still relaxed and not worried about me getting after her a little bit. Good, so she just did a big sigh out, starting to show relaxation. This time we might send her this way. There, so we get a bit of an overreaction, so I put a bit more pressure on. Again, and start driving that hip. Get that inside hind stepping up. Get a bit of bend through her body. There, the rope's going nice and slack now. She's starting to shape up. You can see I'm trying to make a point of how I'm trying to have as little pressure on the halter as possible. Just holding it with my thumb and finger. Trying not to pull on her head. Trying to drive that hip. And you might disengage. Good. And desensitize to make sure she's still relaxed. Good girl. So as you can see, the importance of being able to desensitize and sensitize and go from one to the other. Often people desensitize, get their horse really relaxed, but then they become very dull and unresponsive and lazy. So then you've got to get them more responsive again, but then sometimes that leads to them becoming a bit overreactive and a bit anxious. So then you've got to be able to desensitize again to bring their energy back down. So they've got to be able to go from responsive and traveling around back to standing and relaxed, and then relaxed in the change of direction and the send and while they're traveling around. You want to have that nice mental balance between responsive and relaxation, not anxious and responsive, or relaxed and dull and lazy. So as you can see, Arwen's starting to get to that point now.